Hello children, how are you today? I hope you are doing fine. I am also fine. This is Teacher Terry again. So today we are going to learn to take our religious activities under prayer. And before that, let's sing a song. Sing along with me. Welcome. Prayer is the key, prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Jesus started in prayer and ended in prayer. Prayer is the master key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Jesus started in prayer and ended in prayer. Prayer is the master key. Very good. That song was wow. Prayer is the key. Prayer is what? Is the key. It is the master key. Jesus started in prayer and ended with prayer. So, what is prayer? Yes? What is prayer? Who can tell us what is prayer? Yes? Prayer is talking to God. Prayer is talking to what? Prayer is talking to God. Okay? And where is God? Where is God? God in heaven. Prayer is talking to God in heaven. God lives in heaven. Okay? Yes. So if you are asked where do God live, you'll see what? Our God lives in heaven. Okay? So prayer, it means that we should pray always. Pray always. You should pray. We should pray always as Christians. Okay? Are you a Christian? Yes? Do you go to church? Do you go to Sunday school? Very good. Do you pray in the church? Very good. How do you pray? Yes? Who can pray for us? For example, when we want to eat, how do we pray? Yes, you put your hands together, then you close your eyes like this, then you bow down. Then how will you pray when you're about to eat? You'll say, oh God, bless this food before we take it in Jesus' name. Amen. You should pray always. In the morning, when you are about to take your breakfast, or you want to take, maybe you want to take tea or porridge, how will you pray? Yes, you'll pray, oh Lord, bless this porridge before we take it in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, you should always and always pray. You should always even pray for your parent. You say, God bless my mommy. God bless my daddy. Amen. That's a prayer. And a prayer is talking to God. When you are praying, you are talking to God. And in the Bible, we can see, we are told that Jesus taught his disciples how to do what? How to pray. Yes, Jesus taught his disciples how to pray. And who are the disciples of Jesus? Us as the Christians, we are what? We are the disciples of Jesus. Very good. Yes, so Jesus taught us to pray. In the Bible, this one is a Bible. This one is a what? A Bible. So we are going to read a Bible. And a Bible is a what? It is a holy book of God. A Bible is a holy book of God. And what is written here in the Bible, it's usually true. So, we are going to read a verse where Jesus taught us, his disciples, how to pray. In the Bible, in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 9, we are taught about Lord's Prayer. Do you know how to say our Lord's Prayer? Yes? Very good. Let us say it together. Our Father, who art in heaven, may your holy name be honored. May your kingdom come.
May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today the food we need. Forgive us the wrongs we have done, as we forgive the wrongs that others have done unto us. Do not bring us to hard testing, but keep us safe from the evil one. Amen. So, that is how Jesus taught us how to do what? To pray. You pray for your daily needs. You pray for the forgiveness of sins. When you fight one another, that is wrong. Fighting is what? Is wrong. We should pray for your neighbor too. You pray for your friends. You pray for your teachers. You pray for your parents. So, the Bible says that we should pray always like Jesus did. Okay? Yes. So, from today, practice praying. Everything you do, you should pray first. You should put Jesus in your life first. Okay? Yes. So, from today, I want us to practice praying. Every now and then, let us pray. Even if you are sick, when you pray, Jesus will heal you. He will hand your prayers and he will do what? He will heal you. Okay? Yes. So, thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye!